Come on and put your hands together and begin to bless them. Come on, you can do better than that. Has he done anything for you on tonight?
Yes, yes.
That you need to show some signs. Come on and prove that how much you love him.
Yes.
Come on and give the Lord a praise. Jesus' name. Come on and clap your hands and give me glory. question add. If I was to use, just for a quick think, I would use it. And look at your neighbor and tell your neighbor, cough it up.
Cough it up.
This is a restitution. Cough it up. Glory to God. Amen. I came with this message tonight for the devil. Amen. It's not for the saints, but it's for the devil on tonight. God said to announce to the devil that he has to cough up your goods. How many want your goods coughed up on tonight? God told me that to just to prophesy over the lives of the people that was here on tonight and to release an anointing of restitution in the place. I may not be talking to everyone, but I know I'm talking to one person that has lost some stuff and want to get it back. How many want to get back what the enemy took from you on tonight? I didn't come to play with it on tonight. In the time when so much is taken away from us, what I'm getting ready to say might sound crazy. It looks like and feels like everything is being taken away from us. They want to take away our freedom of speech, our right to defend ourselves, our prophecy. They even dictate to us, what can we eat in school? What can we do in school? What can we do in the street? But how many know that tonight I'm taking it back? Glory to God. They taking away our rights to choose even our health care. They telling us which one to go to, who to go to, what physicians to go to. But I have assignment on tonight, and I am mandated, glory to God, to prophesy to the house and to prophesy to all of those that are hearing my voice that this one word, restitution, glory to God, the devil is going to cough it up. He's coughing up my stuff on tonight.
Yes.
Glory to God. Restitution I'm speaking about is just getting back. I don't care what it is that the government took from you, the IRS, the NSI, the CIA, the DHS, or even the devil himself. If it has been stolen from you, God said to get ready for restitution.
Yes.
Glory to God. There might be many different names or titles, but ultimately it is the devil who is the thief on tonight. Glory to God. The Bible tells us in Proverbs the 6th chapter in the 30th and the 31st verse, it says, man do not despise a thief if he steals to satisfy his soul when he is hungry. But if he has found, he shall restore sevenfold. He shall give all the substance to his house. I don't care what has been stolen from you on tonight. I come to prophesy restitution to you. Restitution is coming to you on tonight. You have caught the thief. You have identified that right on tonight. Glory to God. Just to let you know what restitution is, just in case you didn't know. Glory to God, there's three definitions. Restitution is the act of restoring or a condition of being restored. Number two is restoring of something that is rightfully yours.
Yes, I want it back.
Rightfully yours. Number three is a legal action serving to cause restitution of a previous state. I come to get restitution on tonight. It needs to take back and to take it back like it was brand new. Glory to God. How many know that if you go into the enemy's camp, you got to go in there with power? Glory to God. You can't go in there like a weakling. Glory to God. If there was one thing the Bible is, that it is a record of God restoring. From Genesis all the way to Revelation, is God is a restorer. Glory to God. If there is any testimony, glory to God's ability to restore and to bring restitution, it would have to be in the 37th chapter of Ezekiel during the verses of 1 to 10. Glory to God. If I can rephrase those scriptures, glory to God, that only talks about the valley of the dry bones. Glory to God. Those valley of the dry bones represented the greatness of grief. Glory to God. The greatness of misery. The greatness of loss and the destruction. Glory to God. The very essence of the totality of the word hopelessness. It is a picture of a thief that is in his full destruction of power. Glory to God. That's what the valley of the dry bones is. It's in this full destruction of power. The valley of dry bones represents every area of human needs and brokenness known to humanity. Every sickness, every disease, every bondage, every oppression, every financial struggle, every distress, glory to God, every family strife, every struggle is represented in the valley of the dry bones. If you stop at verse 2, there will be nothing but hopelessness and despair. But into the dreary valley of hopelessness and misery and death came a word from God. God said to Ezekiel, prophesy.
That's it.
He said, prophesy to the bones. Which means that he said, decree and declare the word of the Lord. Prophesy restitution. Prophesy restoration. Yes. Prophesy life. Prophesy resurrection.
Yes.
Prophesy new life. And new beginning.
Yes.
Glory to God. And as he prophesied, the power of God invaded the valley. And as he prophesied, soothes and flood and flesh came upon those bones and skin began to cover them. And as he began to continue to prophesy, there was a noise and a shaking of the bones beginning to come together in perfect order, bones to his bones. This is God's restoring and putting it back and putting it back together the right way.
Yes, yes.
Glory to God. Then he said to continue to prophesy. He told the wind, glory to God, the wind of God began to blow and the breath of God began to fill their lungs, and then they stood up on their feet like a great army. The wind is the power of the Holy Ghost. I don't care how good it looks like or it sounds like, without any anointing, without the Holy Spirit, you ain't got no power.
Yes.
It's just a dead spirit. Glory to God. I'm not talking to somebody tonight. Glory to God. I'm talking to those that want to get back. Glory to God. Who have felt like those bones that you had has been stripped bare, broken into pieces, and hung out to dry. You know who you are tonight. I felt like that at some point in my life. Glory to God. It just felt like everything around me, the devil just snatched everything. But how many know that restoration is coming to the household tonight?
Hallelujah.
Yes.
He has robbed us from our joy. The enemy has robbed us from our peace. Robbed us from our family. But I'm going back and I'm taking it back. Maybe it's your physical. Glory to God. The devil has attacked your body or even your finances. Your finances have dried up. You don't know which way to turn. Glory to God. It could have been in your marriage. He has stolen your joy, your peace. He has stolen your self-respect, your self-esteem. He has stolen your dreams and your hopes for the future. But God said to tell you on tonight, don't write it off. Because it ain't over.
It ain't over. Yes.
It ain't over till God says it's over. Glory to God. God said it's not over. He's getting ready to slew the devil in the gut and make him cough up your goods. Glory to God. How many are ready, glory to God, for the devil to cough up your goods? Glory to God. Whatever you need from the Lord, I dare you to say, cough it up, devil. Sometimes you just need to get mad at the devil. Today, to tell him to cough it up.
Cough it up.
Cough up everything.
Yes, yes.
Well, I'm not here just to tell you. I'm here to prophesy to you. I'm here to prophesy in the authority and anointing of the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
And to declare unto you and prophesy restitution. Glory to God. Restitution in your finances, in your health. Glory to God, in your family, in your home, in your marriage. Glory to God, I prophesy divine reversal. Somebody has been cheated out of their property. Glory to God.